Here's how you build an element relative display in ProcessBook. Now the first thing though you're going to have is some kind of a structure in AF. If you've got a structure, and if that structure has attributes that point to, well, for example, that point to things like these PI tags, that's all you really need. Something where you've got a structure, and that structure should have, like we see in this set of flow meters, this one element called flow meters. Under that flow meters, there are these different elements underneath that, each one of which has an attribute called flow rate. Now, because that attribute is shared among these six here, then we can make an element relative display. They're all going to be relative to which of these flow meters you're currently looking at. So if you've got an AF structure, then go into PI ProcessBook. You need ProcessBook. I'm using ProcessBook version 3.2 here, or later. And let's just build a brand new display. I'll just show you we haven't predefined anything here, just brand new display. I did a PDI file. And the first thing you need to do, let me make this about the right size, is you need to view the option called Element Relative Display. What this does, it brings up this browser. And through this browser, you can start browsing through your AF database. By the way, one of the most common mistakes people make when doing this exercise is they don't do it in the right order. Actually, I guess we can argue about whether it's the right order or not, but if you were to bring this up, this element relative display, before you have a PDI file, you'll notice this is grayed out. I've actually seen tech support calls saying, hey, this is grayed out. I can't browse my AF database. Well, maybe we could have made this a little bit more intuitive, but the fact of the matter is, until you build a display, a PDI file, that will be dimmed out. So, yeah, sorry if you've wasted any time over that. So make sure you've got a brand new display. Make sure you have chosen element relative display. That makes this pane show up. And now you're going to use that to browse through or search through the elements in AF. Now, one of the things I can do without doing any browsing at all is just search. For example, if I know that I'm interested in tanks, I can just type in tanks, click on search, and then find elements of interest called tanks. This shows me all the tanks. Let me get rid of these. Let me show you another way to do it. I could have searched for the word flow with an asterisk. This is going to find all those elements. There we go, all those flow meters. That's actually what I'm interested in for this exercise. Yeah, that have that. But so that's one way we can do it. Let me show you another way, and that is to use this tree structure. Let me remove this. These are elements of interest. In other words, these are the elements that you're currently going to be working with. So, yeah, don't think of this as being your, this is not your tree structure. Your tree structure is over here. This is where you can actually go through the AF database. All this is the elements that you happen to have selected through whatever search criteria you prefer, either through here or through here. So I will choose the second method. Again, this I'll click on here. And what I'm going to say is let me start by looking at, let's say I'm in the Montreal division. So within Montreal, I'm only interested in, I think I'm only going to be interested in the tanks. So one of the things I can do, or not the tanks, but those flow meters, I can just drill down straight to where I'm interested in. Yeah, flow meters. I'll just choose that parent. And then I can leave, as long as this is clicked, search sub-elements. If I leave the name blank, this is simply going to go out and find all those flows. And that's fine. That's what I'd like in this case. So by doing that, it allowed me to find these individual elements. Each element represents a different flow meter. And if we take a look at those flows, let me go back to Montreal here. If we take a look at those, yeah, you'll see each flow meter has a process value called flow rate. Now, this could also have other things. It could have installation date, part number, equipment number, what is the, what orifice type, is it ceramic, is it chrome? All these different things would be different attributes, just like, for example, within tanks. These tanks have a diameter, an inside temperature, a level, et cetera, et cetera. We're just starting with something very simple. It's a simple flow meter object that has a flow rate. So there's only really one thing that I could find here, and that is going to be that flow rate. Okay, we've done exactly about half of what we need to do an element relative display. Now that we have something over here in elements of interest, now we're ready to use the element relative search within these dynamic objects. And I'll choose a trend for my dynamic object, although I could choose other things. I'll click on this. I could choose a bar graph or a value as well. I'm going to go in and build this brand new. Instead of doing a tag search, you'll see there's an option here called element relative. Element relative is going to be relative to whatever element is selected in elements of interest. Boy, I should repeat that. That's very, very important. And it's not typically very intuitive. I mean, who would guess that when you click on a value here and you click on element relative, then what you're talking about is this right here. It's as obvious as we could make it, but it's something that sometimes people miss. So let me state that again. When I build this trend and I choose element relative, we're talking about relative to whatever your currently selected element of interest is. I'll choose element relative. As you can see, it found what I was currently looking at, and it found exactly one thing that it could trend, that flow rate. So I'll choose that. Whoops, I'll move this down. That looks good. And there's my result. E stands for element relative. This is looking at flow rate. Now notice, it didn't say flow rate in YULE FM001. Okay? That's because we're not capturing that context. The context is being supplied by what you select over here. So, and let me just switch this to 7 days. So the big finish then is, as I change context, we're going to change what you're looking at. Because now, you see the context is being passed, and each one of these flow meters has a different resulting PI tag. Okay, let me demonstrate what is probably the single most confusing element or thing about this whole element relative display. I kind of cheated here because I went out and did a search for elements of interest that will not fail. There's absolutely no way that one of these elements does not contain the attribute I'm interested in. That's kind of a setup, because what could easily happen is for you to find things on here that do not have that attribute. So for example, let me remove this element of interest. You notice, of course, the data goes away now. Let me go out and search for everything that has the word flow. There we go. We see flow meters. And these are the ones we were just looking at, right? But what about when you click on, for example, just the first one? You click on the first one, that flow meter is an element that does not contain an attribute called flow rate. It's at the top of that hierarchy. So, you know, although when I click on these, that's fine, but when I click the top of the hierarchy, there is no element there. And the same for this. Now, interestingly enough, these are San Leandro meters. These all have a flow rate, and so do the Houston flow meters. They all have a flow rate. But if you click at the top of the hierarchy, you will not see any data. Give you another example. Let me go ahead and remove everything from here. Let's say you just want to start at that level that we call geography. If I choose geography, that's going to find, it finds a single element, but that element has a huge number of things organized underneath of it. Now, when you drill down through this, when you do get to some element that contains a flow meter, then you will, in fact, see data. But as you traverse this, you will not see anything until you get to an element that contains that. And again, so if I go back, let's go into, instead of Houston, let's go to San Leandro here. We'll go to chemicals, equipment, flow meters. When I find those flow meters, we're in good shape. But that can be confusing. Up until when you find those, you will not see any data on here when you choose an object that does not itself contain the attribute called flow rate. One last thing I'd like to add is to just demonstrate how easy it is to modify this display to show other things. So right now we're just looking at As we said, we're looking at this flow rate. But I know for a fact there's a lot of interesting things I may want to look at these tanks. Now remember, the tanks don't contain a flow rate. It contains other things. So now that that tank has been selected, that's my element of interest, I can go in and modify this to look at anything in that tank. So I'm in build mode. I'll double click on this. Let me get rid of that. I don't need the flow rate anymore. But now when I choose element relative, it's going to be relative to this tank. If I choose that, look at all the things available to me. I can see what the concentration is, the inside temperature. I can select these items and then move them. I'll hold down Control and select them one at a time. I can move them down, and then these are the things we can be looking at. This is actually a calculation. I'll select that, move that down. Change that to multiple scales so we can see. Well, that's pretty ugly, but it's just showing us that the data's there. And as you can see, as I switch from one tank to the next, it was that easy to switch this over. Now I've got a nice little engine for looking at all my tanks. I'm currently looking at San Leandro tanks, but I also have tanks in other cities, so I can go out here, chemicals, equipment. Let's look at the tanks. I got two tanks in Houston, and here's how I can look at those Houston tanks.